Hey there, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'll do a comparison between the TFSA, known as the Tax-Free Savings Account, and the RRSP, known as the Registered Retirement Savings Plan. I will touch upon some key differences between both accounts, weighing both the benefits and drawbacks, and when exactly it may be the ideal time to use either account. For those of you who are new, my name is Cash, and on the channel, I do focus on the markets. I provide my thoughts and insights on the market and really try to focus on sharing opportunities to build wealth. For those of you who are not entirely familiar with the TFSA or the RRSP, or perhaps you're just looking for a bit of a refresher, do feel free to check out my previous videos on the channel or in my personal finance playlist to get you up to speed. I've broken down both the TFSA and the RRSP and explained the key highlights for each account. In my opinion, it's tough to say one account is better than the other. Everyone's situation is unique. So in this video, rather than proving a winner of the two, I am going to try to explain the differences in the most concise way possible and allow you to make your judgment of what is the most beneficial for yourself and or your family situation. However, in my opinion, if you are in a position to use both accounts where you have surplus at the end of the year, that would be ideal. Now, if we look at some of the differences between the TFSA and the RRSP, any unused allowable contribution room in either the RRSP or the TFSA can be carried forward. So if you choose not to contribute the allowed contribution amount for that year, you can always do so the following year. However, the RRSP does not allow you to recontribute any prior contributed income that you withdraw from the account. So, say your total contribution limit in the RRSP is $60,000 and you have contributed this full amount. If you choose to withdraw $10,000 from the RRSP moving forward, you will not be able to recontribute that original $10,000. Therefore, your new total set contribution limit in the RRSP goes to $50,000. This differs from a TFSA account where any money that you do withdraw can be added back to the account the following year. Going back to the RRSP, however, of course, if you do show an income the following year, you can always contribute to the RRSP the 18% up to the maximum limit, about $27,800. So in this example, if you show a gross income of $60,000 in 2021, you can contribute $10,800 or 18% of $60,000 income back to the RRSP, which would bring your RRSP contribution limit from $50,000 up to $60,800. It is important to establish your main purpose when you choose to set aside your income to these accounts. The RRSP is built as a long-term retirement vehicle to build your wealth in the account over time and provide you an income when you retire. The RRSP can really bear fruit for someone who falls under a high income tax bracket at the present moment. What you can do if you fall under a high income tax bracket is you can contribute to the RRSP and then use a tax refund that is provided to you to make up for the taxes that you save and put it towards the TFSA. It is ideal to only start depleting the RRSP in your later years when you eventually fall into a lower tax bracket to end up paying less taxes. Therefore, if you are planning for the long term, the RRSP is a good option. If you do feel that you may need personal liquidity sooner than later and may need to withdraw the funds in the short term, the TFSA may act as a better suited vehicle as you can always recontribute the withdrawn amount the following year. And although taxes are already paid on the money when it is first put into the TFSA, there are no additional taxes that need to be paid if you choose to withdraw. Generally, if you fall under a lower income tax bracket, I would say making $45,000 or less, it may be more beneficial to contribute first to the TFSA. If your income starts to substantially increase over the years, then you may start considering the RRSP to be able to offset more income tax. When we look at the tax benefit plans associated with both registered accounts, if you are looking to purchase your first home or build, with the RRSP, you do have access to the home buyer's plan. The HBP allows you to withdraw up to $35,000 from the RRSP to put towards your first home purchase or build without any interest or taxes needing to be paid on that amount. It is basically an interest-free loan. The $35,000 does need to be paid back into the RRSP within 15 years. So if you are looking to purchase a first home sooner than later, you may feel inclined to start contributing towards an RRSP. Even as a hypothetical, if you were making an income of $70,000 gross, at your tax rate, you would be taxed anywhere between $8,000 to $9,000 on that $35,000 amount. So it's a great way to use the full $35,000 amount towards your first home, as opposed to say $26,000 after having to pay taxes. Looking at which account can build you more wealth over time, if we take this standard example, assuming you make RRSP contributions, claim them when you file your tax income, and use the tax benefits to further top up your investment, and also assuming that your income tax rate at withdrawal is the same for the TFSA at 30%, and the annual returns in each account are also the same at 6%, your net return at the end of it all would be the same. However, this may be seen as a skewed chart, as the tax rates along with the returns will likely differ. In terms of your overall net return, in which account is a better option, it can be variable depending on a few different factors, which may include what returns on your investments you are receiving in the TFSA versus the RRSP, what is your tax bracket at when you choose to contribute to either the TFSA or RRSP, and what income tax bracket you fall under when you choose to withdraw from the RRSP. Regardless, if the right investments are made, the power of compounding will show its magic in the long run in both accounts. A few other things to note when looking at the TFSA versus the RRSP. The spousal RRSP is an option where a spouse can contribute to an account and engage in income splitting, therefore paying less taxes overall. The TFSA is contributed with after-tax dollars. You will eventually be forced to take money out of the RRSP when you turn 71. However, there is no maturity date for you to have to start withdrawing from your TFSA. If you do have beneficiaries, the account will be passed over to. The TFSA can potentially grow further. You can over-contribute up to $2,000 in the RRSP. The TFSA is more strict when it comes to over-contribution, and you will be penalized if you do go over the limit. In terms of what you can invest in, you have access to virtually all the same investment assets for both the TFSA or RRSP. However, if you do plan to invest in US and other foreign companies, and a big reason for that is to receive dividends, one thing to note is that in an RRSP, there is no withholding tax on US dividends. However, in a TFSA, you are subject between 10 to 15% withholding tax, so your net gains would be lower on the US dividends you get from the company. However, to reiterate, any gains made on Canadian stocks and US stocks themselves in a TFSA are tax-free. Well, that's it for the video. I tried to touch upon most of the key highlights. However, if I did miss anything, I will add a comment below. If anyone has any questions or concerns, do also feel free to leave a comment below and I'll respond to them right away. For anyone that had trouble understanding anything and maybe at more of a beginner level, as mentioned, do feel free to watch my previous videos breaking down the TFSA and the RRSP, and feel free to reach out as I would love to explain to you in further detail.